Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to count the number of vowel characters that is present in a string in C++. So let's get started. So first let me input a string variable. So it's going to be string s, and it's going to be cout enter a string. So first let me like have a single input string, and after that I will be showing you how to input a whole sentence. I'll be showing you both, okay? So it's going to be C in s. And for this here, we will be using a for loop and a if condition with many or clauses. Okay, so I will explain you while typing it. So it's going to be for int I equal to 0, I less than s dot, we will be having the length function, I plus plus. So basically, we will be iterating through each character of the string, and we'll be having a if condition. And in this if condition, we will check whether that character is A or E or I or U. And if the particular character in the string is equal to these vowels, we will just increment the counter by 1. So for each iteration, if this if condition is true, we will iterate the count by 1. So simple. So for the count, we need to have a count variable. So let me just come here, and it's going to be int. You can just have it at the top to be more clear. So it's going to be int count equal to 0. We need to initialize to 0 so that it doesn't, we aren't going to get an error or a garbage value. So it's always better to initialize a variable to 0 at first, especially count and sum. So now coming to the if condition, it's going to be if our string name of I equal to, within double quotes or single quotes, I'll go with single quotes, A. Okay, and here we need to use the or. So this is how you do it. So I will just now copy it. Copy the entire thing, basically just copy the entire thing, paste it, A, E, I, O and U, and here we can just change it to E, I, O and U. And I hope you know about OR condition. In case of AND, even only if all the condition are true, AND will return true. But in case of OR, even if any one of this particular thing is true, it returns true. So basically, even if you only have E, this if condition is going to be true. Okay, so it works that way. So here inside this count plus plus, yeah, and at the after the for loop is over, like you need to come outside the for loop. Okay, and here we will be putting C out. I'll just print the count, simple. Yeah, so this is the code, that's it. So if I just now run it, after this I will show you how to input a sentence. Okay, so enter a string, I will go with hello. So I think there here are two vowels, E and O. So if I just hit enter, we need to get the output as 2. So here you can see we have got the output as 2. This is working absolutely fine. So now I will show you a way how we can get a whole sentence as input. So exactly is going to be the same thing, but rather than C in, we will be using the get line. Okay, so it's going to be get line, and within bracket we need to put C in, comma, our string variable name, which is yes. Okay, I think we need to import a header file for getline. So let me just now run and check. So no input, okay, no header file needed. So we can now input a sentence with spaces. So it's going to be hello world. So how many vowels? It's E, O, another O, so 3 vowels. I will put a space and I will put I, so which makes it 4 vowels now. So if I hit enter, we need to get the output as 4. So here you can see I got the output as 4. So this is working perfectly, and this is the code, guys. So simple. We are just iterating it and having a if condition. Simple. So we need to have within double quotes. Okay, here is the important thing, and it's equality. So it's s of I, which means that we are iterating through each character in the string. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I have also done many other tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React, JS, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.